Thank you. may be seated. Well, on behalf of these two families, I want to welcome you to Maranatha Bible Church for Derek and Liz's wedding. It's a day we've been looking forward to for a long time, and I know that they are thrilled that you are here to support them in a very big day. I want to begin our service with a word of prayer, so would you bow your heads, please, and let's commit this ceremony to the Lord. Our God and Father, we thank you for today. This is the day that you have ordained for Derek and Liz to be married. And we thank you that in your sovereign plan, you have brought them to this point. Lord, we thank you for the gift of marriage. It is your kindness to us. It is your mercy to us. You have demonstrated your common grace to us in giving us companions and friendship. And we thank you that that takes place in the context of marriage. And we thank you, Lord, for the grace that you've exhibited towards Derek in drawing him to yourself and bringing him to this point. We thank you for Liz and the grace that you've demonstrated in her life and bringing her to this point to be married. And so, Lord, this ceremony really is about you. It is about Derek and Liz, and it is about the work that you're going to do in them and through them, but ultimately, this is about you because you're the one who's writing their story. And so, Lord, as this ceremony begins, and as they begin their marriage, we ask that Jesus Christ will be exalted, and that you will be honored and glorified as we meet together today. It's in your Son's precious name that we pray. Amen.
Dearly beloved, we are gathered here in the sight of God and in the presence of these witnesses to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony, which is an honorable estate instituted of God and signifying unto us the mystical union which exists between Christ and his church, which holy estate Christ adorned and beautified with his presence in Cana of Galilee. It is therefore not to be entered into unadvisedly, but reverently, discreetly, and in the fear of God. In this holy estate, these two persons come now to be joined. Who gives this woman to be married to this man? I require and charge both of you, as you stand in the presence of God, to remember that love and loyalty alone will avail as the foundation of a happy and enduring home. No other human ties are more tender, and no other vows more sacred than those you now assume. If these solemn vows be kept unviolated, and if steadfastly you endeavor to do the will of your Heavenly Father, your life will be full of joy, and the home which you are now establishing will abide in peace. Derek and Elizabeth, it is my personal charge to you that in your marriage you love one another as God has loved you with an agape love. Through all the memories that you will make together, see his blessings in those. And know that this union between the two of you takes three. A successful Christian marriage is one with God at the center of it, leading and guiding the home. Derek, do you take this woman to be thy wedded wife, to live together in holy estate of matrimony? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep thee only unto her so long as you both shall live?
I do.
And Elizabeth, do you take this man to be thy wedded husband, to live together in the holy state of matrimony? Will you love him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep thee only unto him, so long as you both shall live? I, Derek Gilliland.
I, Derek Gilliland.
Take thee, Elizabeth Loesch.
Take thee, Elizabeth Loesch.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse, for richer, for poor.
For better, for worse, for richer, for poor.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And thereto I promise thee my faithfulness.
And thereto I promise thee my faithfulness.
I, Elizabeth Loesch,
take thee, Derek Gilliland,
to be my wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward,
for better, for worse, for richer,
for poor, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part. According to God's holy ordinance, and thereto I promise thee my faithfulness. These rings are an outward and visible sign of an inward and spiritual grace, signifying unto all the uniting of this man and this woman in holy matrimony through the Church of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
There must be a God, I believe it's true, 'cause I can see his love when I look at you. And he must have a plan for this crazy life, because he brought you here and placed you by my side. 'Cause I have never been so sure of anything before, like I am in this moment here with you. And now, for better or for worse, are so much more than only words. And I pray every day will be the proof that I mean what I say when I say I do. Yeah, I mean what I say when I say I do. Oh. You see, these hands you hold will always hold you when the strength you have, it just ain't strong enough. And what tomorrow brings, only time will tell. But I will stand by you in sickness and in health, 'cause I have never been so sure of anything before, like I am in this moment here with you. And now, for better or for worse, are so much more than only words. And I pray every day will be the proof that I mean what I say when I say I do. Yeah, I mean what I say when I say take my hand and take this ring, and know that I will always love you through anything. Yeah. And as the years march on, like a beating heart, and I will live these words till death do us part. And I have never been so sure of anything before, like I am in this moment here with you. And now for better or for worse, are so much more than only words. And I pray everything will be the proof that I mean what I say when I say I do. Yeah, I mean what I say when I say I do.
Heavenly Father, Derek and Elizabeth have been a blessing in their lives, of their friends and their families throughout the years. And today, as we come together to witness the unity of your servants, our prayer is that you will bless their lives together. We pray that you will preserve and keep them in their marriage and in their service to you. Lead and guide their lives by your Spirit as they faithfully walk in your pathway. Give them strength daily as they follow you together. And may you, Lord, always be the center of their union. We pray this in Jesus' holy name, and amen. For as much as Derek and Elizabeth have consented together in holy wedlock, and thereto have pledged their faithfulness one to another, and have declared the same by joining hands and by giving and receiving a ring, I pronounce that they are husband and wife together, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Those whom God hath joined together, let no man put asunder. Derek, you may kiss your bride. Get your bouquet. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Derek Gilliland.